ready for the truth?
Hello, and welcome to this Question Entertainment Extra, the career of
writer and director M. Night Shyamalan.
We just reviewed his latest movie, The Happening, and I didn't like it. Emily thought it was entertaining, but we both agreed it was his worst offering yet. And really, I do believe he is the best writer-director working right now. His movies are amazing. So it seemed very unfair to leave you with that one review and not give you an overview of his very amazing career and suggest some other movies that you might want to check out if you haven't before. So in 1992, M. Night Shyamalan put his first movie out. It was an independent called Praying with Anger. He not only wrote and directed that, he also starred in it. I hear it was funded by his parents and it's only available on VHS in England. So I've never seen it and I can't tell you anything about it beyond that. If you know how to see it, if you have any clue on that one, please let me know. Tell me in the comments below. I would love to see that movie. In 1998, he put out his first Hollywood film called Wide Awake. It was about a little boy going to Catholic school. His beloved grandfather dies, and it sets him off on a search to find God. It also features Rosie O'Donnell playing a baseball-loving nun who is one of the teachers at the school. And all in all, this is a really entertaining film, and you see sort of the birth of a lot of ideas and themes that are going to be very important in his later career. It's great because it's this boy looking for God, and it has a real Charles Schultz, Charlie Brown sort of feel, in that they're little kids and they're dealing with death and God and the meaning of life in the vocabulary of a seventh grader. Actually, not sure what grade he is, but it gives it the kind of accessibility you find in like a Charlie Brown Christmas. So in this movie, not only is it a search for God, but along the way he checks out some other religions outside of Christianity, but they're all shown silly and as dead ends. By the end, he really does get it right. The grandfather believes in God, trusts God to bring him to heaven. He goes to church and he sees God working in his life around him. The only spiritually weird part is at one point he asks his teacher, the Rosie O'Donnell character, and he asks if all non-Catholics are going to hell. This is never really resolved in a very amusing scene. The bell rings before she can really explain what's going on. Other than that, it's a solid movie spiritually as well as just a fun movie. Outside of a couple cuss words, I'd say a fun family movie. Then in 1999, he ended up becoming a household name, for those of you who could pronounce it, with his movie The Sixth Sense. This is where Bruce Willis plays a child psychologist and his latest case utters the now iconic line, "I see dead people." This is the movie that establishes who we think of when we think of M. Night Shyamalan. The movie's amazing. It's known for its twist ending, which unfortunately has probably been ruined for you at some point if you haven't seen it. But it does a really great job of mixing these almost horror elements with ghosts and things with real, genuine humanity. The unfortunate part about this is that while I see it could be used as maybe a parable, like this boy has to learn to deal with these ghosts, these dead people all around him, so the Christian church needs to deal with the people around us who, though living, are spiritually dead. I do think he's using ghosts as a fantasy element, but enough people look at ghosts as real that this looks like it's supporting that sort of idea. More troubling, it seems to suggest that all you need to go to heaven is to let go of your hurts in life, which is unfortunate. In 1999, he was also one of the co-authors of the screenplay for Stuart Little, the only movie he wrote but didn't direct. I've never actually been able to sit through all of that film, so I can't tell you a whole lot beyond that. Then in the year 2000, he put out Unbreakable, once again with Bruce Willis, but this time also Samuel L. Jackson. Here, Willis plays a security guard. He feels like his life is a dead end. He thinks he's just gonna leave his wife and child and move to New York and start over. On the way to New York for a job interview, he's in a train wreck where he is the only one to survive and he's unscratched. This is where the Samuel L. Jackson character comes in. He plays Elijah, who owns a comic book art gallery. It's not a comic book shop. They have framed art from comic books. And he thinks that the train accident has proven that Bruce Willis is a real-life superhero. This was an exciting movie to watch. I think it's one of the most perfectly constructed movies I've ever seen. Everything in the movie is about progressing the story. Not only does this have an amazing twist ending, they even have a character given the line, "This one has a twist ending." We see a lot of the elements from the earlier two films coming together. We have a search for meaning and significance, and we have bizarre fantasy elements being thrown in, and they really act as sort of a spice that brings out the true flavor of the human experience. And it deals with some great themes. He thinks his life is meaningless, he's not doing anything, and he wants to throw away everything as opposed to fixing himself. He was made that way by God. He's gotta figure out what it is God would want him to do. Very light, but it is in there. You also see a man who's given up on his marriage and makes that journey back. It's by no means as explicit as a Rick Warren book or Kirk Cameron in Fireproof, but this movie does let us know we need purpose in life. We need to find what God wants us to do, and that marriage takes work and it's worth giving that work to. Then in 2002, he came out with my personal favorite of his, Signs, starring Mel Gibson and Joaquin Phoenix. Anybody who's told me they saw the movie and didn't like it, usually what it was is they thought it was going to be about aliens and crop circles. And frankly, that's what the ads told you. I saw an interview with him where he was saying that when he did Unbreakable, Unbreakable wasn't The Sixth Sense. And The Sixth Sense was sort of a scary movie. Unbreakable was nothing like that, but the ad made it look like it was another frightening movie and it was another Sixth Sense. And he was saying that since then, all his ads look like that. So Signs, on the onset, seems to be about aliens. It's much more than that, and this is why I love that movie. We meet a pastor whose wife has died in a horrible car accident. He now is raising his two little kids with the help of his younger brother who's living in the loft next door. He's not only given up his job as an Episcopal minister, he's given up on God. He's decided that life is just random mistakes and he can't believe in a God who would let his wife die. Then they find a crop circle in their cornfield, which that's kind of cool anyway, because crop circles, anytime they've really been found, it's like in wheat or something, a crop that can easily be broken, not in a cornfield. So that was pretty cool. But they find crop circles in their cornfield. Then they start finding out that these crop circles are showing up all over the world. And this is the interesting thing. The movie then creates this tension as to, is this real or is this a giant hoax? And then in an amazing scene in the middle, it turns out this movie isn't about whether or not there are aliens. Because the possibility of aliens is just the next horrible thing that could happen. What it's really about is, do you believe in God? Do you trust in God? Because if there's a God, aliens or not, whatever the next thing happens, he's going to take care of you. If there's no God, might as well be aliens or whatever. You're just there, you're alone, and it's going to be bad. This movie also parallels a lot of things Aragon says in The Two Towers. Actually, whenever I'm showing The Two Towers to people, I first show the scene from Signs. Okay, I've only done it once, but I will do it again. I promise. You have this tension about God and faith. You also have just some beautiful movie making going on. The father's relationship with God mirrored with his son's relationship with him. You also have what I think are some just beautiful nods to Alfred Hitchcock. And I believe M. Night Shyamalan has proven himself to be up there with Hitchcock. Signs is also really good because it will break really tense moments with some very funny lines. Towards the end of the movie, there's this scene that's one of the most tense scenes in the film where, to break the tension for his family, Mel Gibson's character starts telling the kids about the days they were born. You're seeing this beautiful family moment in the midst of really being legitimately scared. It's fantastic, not only what he does with a movie and as a storyteller, but also what he communicates about God.
Make geometric shapes the size of a football field.
Can't be by hand, it's too perfect.
Some animals around the county have been acting funny.
Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of what's happening.